How's it going, everybody? This is Rusty here at FCP Euro, and today we're going to be doing an oil service on the 3-liter turbo commonly found in the Audi and Porsche vehicles, as well as this Audi S5 here behind me. So what I have in front of me is the service kit for the 3-liter vehicle here, including about 8 quarts of oil, the oil filter, along with the gasket for the oil filter housing, the crush washer, as well as the drain plug, which is a one-time use torque to yield item. It's imperative that you have the oil serviced at a minimum of at least 5,000 miles in at least 1 year. This is the lifeblood of the vehicle, and it's the one way to ensure that the vehicle will have the longest life possible. Now that we've gone over everything in the kit, let's get into some tools you'll need to tackle the job yourself. So the main tools you'll need for this job, not too many of them, but the 3/8 ratchet is highly suggested. Something a little bit longer to give you a little bit of leverage. I prefer an extension to offset the oil filter socket, and then the oil filter socket is a 32 millimeter socket. The drain plug is a T45, and then you will need to remove the belly pan, which is a T25 and a T30 from underneath. We also suggest to use a torque wrench to torque the drain plug as well as the oil filter up above. So now that we know what we need, let's go ahead and get into it. All right, so for starters, the oil change is going to start up top. The oil filter is located just below the engine cover, so we're just going to go ahead and pop it off the grommets. And then before you actually release the oil filter from the oil filter housing, it's good practice to have a rag around it. It will start to lose a little bit of oil as you release the filter from the housing, and then definitely have a second rag handy so you don't drip it all over the car. So we've just got a 32 millimeter socket here. Not necessarily, it doesn't have to be a low profile socket. Probably could get onto it with a wrench as well. Personally, I like to leave this open while doing the service to just let everything flow through. Crack the oil cap as well. My rule of thumb is put the oil cap in the hood latch because it's a lot cheaper if you break the oil cap than if you forget to put the oil cap on the car. All right, so we've got the car up in the air. Normally we would have a belly pan underneath here covering the majority of what you see from the front of the bumper to the subframe. We've already had that off. Did have a lot of missing hardware and it was rather damaged, so we will show that in another video if you'd like to tune in for other DIYs. Otherwise, there is quite a sufficient amount of oil leaks. If this is something you have as well, there's a potential for a couple of different oil leaks. The main one that we actually have another DIY on is the oil filter housing from up above, where we had just removed the oil filter. Otherwise, this is a great time to just clean everything off. If you've just bought the car or you're just now seeing a leak, during the oil change, clean everything off, and then on your next one, you can kind of get a better idea of where that oil is coming from. So it is going to be a T45 in the oil pan here, and it is a rather shallow T45, so make sure that your Torx bit, first of all, is a good T45 with not too many rounded corners, and also make sure you're seated securely in there. If you're on your back on the garage floor, this may be rather difficult, but just keep it in mind. I like to keep a hand on the back side of the ratchet, keep it firmly pressed in there, and then give it a good snap. As soon as you release that, it will start to leak oil. So we're gonna go ahead and let this drain for a minute. So once the oil's kind of at a steady drip here and no longer has a stream coming out, you can more or less put the drain plug back in, but obviously be my guest, let the oil drain as long as you'd like. We're gonna go ahead and put this one back in now. Before you install that drain plug, make sure that your old drain plug has the washer on it. You do not want to double gasket that. That will definitely cause an oil leak. We're gonna be torquing this to 30 Newton meters. Once you clean everything up, now is a good time to leave the belly pan off, whether you're doing it on a lift or at the home garage. Leave the belly pan off so that we can visually see the drain plug here, whether it's leaking or not. If you torqued it, it shouldn't be. If you just hand tightened it, it's definitely a good idea to just get a double check once the vehicle's got some oil in it before we start it up. All right, so before we fill it up with oil, let's go ahead and replace the oil filter, which we've had out from before, making sure that we drain everything out. It just clicks into place. Sometimes you may need to give it a little bit of a turn. For the O-ring, personally, I like to just grab a rag and pinch so that you get a little bit right there. Grab it with your finger. That comes off nice and easy. Oh, now new oil filter will click into place just like the removal. New O-ring, put a little bit of the residual oil that you have from removing the old O-ring. Get it around there, making sure that you get it seated in the correct groove. All Not to be confused, one step up, you want to go to the very bottom. And then just install by hand before torquing down to make sure that the threads are not cross-threaded. Removing that rag so you make sure it doesn't pinch in there. And then when it's too tight to spin by hand, we can grab our tools and start tightening that up. All right, so similar to the drain plug, you don't absolutely need a torque wrench. However, the cap on the oil filter housing is plastic, as well as the factory housing itself. So the specification is on the top of the cap. If you do forget, it is 25 Newton meters. And using a 32 millimeter socket, just gonna go ahead, make sure that's seated. If you have any resistance while you're getting to this point, more than likely you're not correctly seated in that filter housing, so you may be cross-threading it. And that's that. All right, so the kit comes with about 8 quarts, a little bit for top off and a little bit for the additional oil that may be required. Vehicle takes about 7.25 quarts. So we're gonna go ahead and start the vehicle with a little bit left in the jug and two of these in there, roughly about 7 quarts. The car does not come with a dipstick. There is a little plug right here at the dealership, or if you are at the house and you do have an extractor, you're more than welcome to suck the oil out from here. However, we've done it the old fashioned way with the drain plug, the filter, and the gasket. Being that the car doesn't have a dipstick, we do have to rely on the instrument cluster to tell us how much oil is in the car. So you don't want to overfill it, and you certainly don't want to underfill it. Being that this vehicle's got about 75,000 miles on it, the oil cap's most likely the original unit. I tend to like to flip the gasket over to get a fresh seal on there. That way we get a nice fresh oil cap for another 75,000 miles. While you've got the vehicle warming up and setting the oil level, get into the main menu here. From the vehicle menu, we're gonna hit the button off to the side. We're gonna go down to service and checks at the very bottom. We're gonna get into service intervals, and then there'll be a reset oil change interval there. We're gonna select that. Yes, we do, because we just changed the oil. Oil interval has been reset. You will notice that that only resets the oil service at the top of the screen. The inspection at the bottom that reads 12,900 miles or 371 days has to be reset with the scan tool. That is basically just doing a full inspection on the car, checking brakes, tires, what have you, and inspecting the vehicle for any possible service. If you don't have the ability to do this, you may have to find yourself a dealership local to you or a shop that has a scan tool available to reset this. But otherwise, we can go into the oil level next once we got the vehicle up to operating temperature. You do have an oil temperature gauge on the dash, roughly below 190. After the vehicle has been idling for some time, you should be able to get a reading on the oil level. Select the oil level. As you can see, we're just at the minimum mark, but that's okay. We have more than enough room to adjust the oil level. Obviously, if you were at max, you wouldn't want to add anything. And if you were above that, you'd get a warning level that you are overfilled. So at this time, we're going to shut the car down and adjust the oil level to spec. All right, so we're just going to add a little bit under a full quart. Again, we have just about a quart left in this jug, so we're going to go ahead and add just a little bit and adjust as needed. It's a lot easier to add than it is to remove. So you don't have to necessarily start the car back up. Once the vehicle is at operating temperature, you can add oil and come back here and check it as needed. We're gonna try to get it up into the 80% full range. Obviously, if you're driving the car spiritedly, you wanna leave a little bit of room for the oil to expand with temperature, and certainly don't wanna be driving around with a quart low. So we're gonna try to get it between 50 and 100%. But you can see here, we've got about 60% full. So we're gonna go ahead and add just a little bit more, careful not to add too much. Now that you've successfully completed an oil change on your 3-liter equipped vehicle, let's go ahead and reinstall the engine cover. Give it a little tug, make sure it's firmly installed. So if you enjoyed today's video, please hit that like button at the bottom, subscribe for more DIYs coming in the future, and if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, feel free to drop them in the comments section below. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll catch you on the next one.